Ice is melting over the Arctic. All of this ice used to block ships from going through, and now it's all opening up. But is the Northwest Passage being oversold as an opportunity for the North and maritime trade?
Oh, for just one time, I would take the Northwest Passage.
So Arctic routes are only shorter for some routes, but not for all. For connecting Northern Europe and East Asia, the Arctic makes sense. But to trade goods from or to South Asia, South America, Africa, or the Middle East, going through the Arctic is not shorter. But these are the regions where many of the emerging markets are. Arctic routes open up in spring and freeze up again in late autumn. So Arctic shipping is seasonal and only possible in large scale during the summer months. When exactly the routes are opening up and closing again cannot be exactly predicted. So ship owners face a lot of uncertainty as to when exactly they can send their ships through the Arctic. Arctic trade routes are not always faster. The main problem is the unreliability of Arctic routes. Even with less ice, the Arctic remains a harsh and dangerous environment. Bad weather and floating ice can make it very hard for seafarers to stick to tight timetables. A warmer Arctic can also mean more difficult conditions for shipping. Warmer weather in the Arctic might lead to worse weather conditions, like increased storm frequencies and more loose ice in form of ice floes and icebergs, which can be more dangerous for ships than thin but fast ice. Scientific models show waters as ice-free when there is less than 15% of ice. This means there might still be icebergs and ice floes around. Especially along the Russian coast, there are many areas with quite shallow waters where big and heavy ships can't go through since they would run aground. The competitors to Arctic routes are also active. The extension of the Panama Canal was completed in June 2016, which doubles the cargo capacity of the waterway and made it accessible for even larger ships which cannot pass the shallow waters of some Arctic routes. Oil and gas production is finite and risky, and people on the land who live in the Arctic do not benefit if a ship just passes by. In other words, the Arctic will not become a new major shipping region for international maritime trade. But regional shipping will increase, for example, in form of supplies for oil and gas projects in the Russian Arctic and transport of these extracted resources from the Arctic to markets, especially in Asia.
Oh, for just one time, I would take the Northwest Passage.
There are many risks associated with shipping and oil and gas development in a fragile ecosystem like the Arctic, ranging from oil spills from ships or platforms, air pollution from ship emissions, and lacking search and rescue infrastructure. Developing oil and gas in the Arctic and shipping it to markets is surely not conducive to reaching the ambitious climate targets.
Oh, for just one time, I would take the Northwest Passage.